Make yourself comfortable and close your eyes. Visualize, imagine, and feel yourself standing in a very long stone corridor of a large medieval castle. As you walk slowly along the corridor, you can hear your feet on the stone floor as you walk. With each step you take along this very long corridor, feel yourself relaxing more and more. The corridor begins to curve in a spiral, and as you walk further on, at the end of the corridor, you can see a large library room full of books. Enter the library and feel yourself entering into an energy field of peace and tranquility. It is like stepping into a very sacred room. Everything is quiet and calm. As you look around, you can see books lining the walls from the floor all the way up to the top of the ceiling. You venture further into the very large library. You notice one shelf empty and move towards it. Near the window, you can see dusty leather books on the floor. Walk over to the books and pick up one of the large heavy books. You find a duster near the books and you begin to slowly dust the book. These books feel magical. With each book you dust, you will find yourself entering into a deeper state of relaxation. Just dust the book in your hand and feel yourself drifting more easily into a deeper state of trance. Continue to listen to my voice, but just focus on the book as you slowly wipe away the cobwebs and dust. Gently place this large book slowly onto the shelf and slide it into position. Pick up another book. And as you feel the duster gently sweep up and over the skin of the book, feel yourself drifting further and further into a deep, deep state of trance. slides into place so slowly and gently. Feel yourself relaxing further and further. Just continue now on to your next book. Remember that with each book you dust, you can feel yourself moving further and further into a deep, relaxed trance. Each sweeping movement you make with your duster is taking you into a deeper feeling of relaxing serenity. You are now in a very deep level of relaxation and trance than you have ever been before. Turn around and exit the library. Continue to go down the long, winding corridor towards where you came from. As you move through the corridor, once more, with each echo of your feet upon the stone floor, feel the energy of the echo vibrating and relaxing you more and more. As you move down, down, down the corridor, at the end of the corridor you can see a very large dark oak door with a golden hoop for a handle. Take hold of the hoop and tap it on the door. The doorway opens, and on the other side, you see an old man with white hair. He welcomes you and asks if you seek the light. You smile and say yes. The man tells you to come with him. You enter into a very dark passage with steps leading down into the underground of the castle. You begin to descend down the steps, and on each step down, you're going to count the steps. With each count, you will feel yourself going deeper and deeper into trance. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. You stand on a small ledge the man smiles at you. He asks if you are all right, and you nod. He tells you that as you venture deeper into the bowels of the earth, the energies around you will become very strong. Ahead looks very dark, but as the man holds up his arm, you can see light coming out from the center of his palm, lighting your way. You begin to descend once more. Again, as you count each step down, you feel yourself, with the help of the energy, moving into a higher state of consciousness, where time and space will cease to exist. Everything feels woolly and ethereal. You begin to descend. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. You can feel strong life force energy around you. The man stops, and as you look before you, you can see a cavern opening with steps leading down into a dark abyss. The man tells you that to get to the halls of life, you must proceed through the halls of the dead. He asks if you are ready to venture forward, and you nod your head. He raises his right hand over your head, and you feel and see a shield of white light forming around you. The power of this light shield is very powerful. Take 1 minute to acclimatize to this white shield energy. Thank you. It is time to move on. Side by side, you walk with the man and begin to descend the steps of the cavern. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. The man tells you there are just a further 30 steps down to the halls of death. You make your way towards the last section of stairs, and with each step down, you will feel your body relaxing more and more. The man tells you that this time you must remain quiet, and that he will now count the steps for you. He asks you to say to yourself the word down with each step you take. He tells you he will count down from 30 to 1, 30, 29, 28, 27, 26, 25, 24, 23, 22, 21, 20, 19, 18, 17, 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. You find yourself at the bottom of the cavern, and through an archway you see a corridor guarded by very large statues of Egyptian gods. At the end of the corridor are two large square doors. In front of the doors are two sphinxes, one black and one white. The man stands before the sphinxes, and from his hands he emits two rays of light into their eyes. You hear the doors move with a large grating sound as the doors slowly begin to open. The man tells you, do not show fear. Here lies the bodies of men. While their bodies sleep, their souls are incarnate elsewhere, evolving and growing. You will not be harmed. It is merely a passage from one doorway to another. As you make your way through the Hall of the Dead, the man tells you, all souls are born from darkness, and it is the light that gives you life. From the darkness of your mother's womb, you were brought into the light of life. All is merely a passage of time and space. Understand that although a body can be bound, the mind cannot. Your thoughts are yours to do with as you wish. You can create a prison for yourself, a life of limitation. Or you can embrace life and use free thought to create what you will. The energy of the room is not as you expected it to be. You can feel a warm, peaceful energy surrounding you, supporting and nurturing you. The man tells you it is not your time to sleep here, so you must not dwell here for too long. You continue to follow him through the long, dark room. You reach the end of the hall, and before you, you see another set of doors. Set in front of the doors on the floor is a small pyramid made of quartz crystal. The man tells you to pick up the crystal. If you can pick up the crystal, you will be allowed to continue your journey. As you touch the quartz crystal pyramid, you feel a surge of energy enter into your hand and move through your arm and into your heart. The pyramid sits perfectly in the palm of your hand. As you stand before the doors, they slowly swing out towards you and open. You see before you another deep cavern with very steep steps leading down into further darkness. You can feel your energy shield glowing, lighting the way for you. As you follow the man further into the darkness, as you begin to make your way down the steps, once more with each step down, you feel yourself becoming heavier and heavier, completely relaxing. More and more as you go down, 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 down. You arrive at another chamber, and you see this chamber is carved into the stone in the shape of a pyramid. Welcome to the halls of life, the man tells you. As you near the pyramid, you see an entranceway opening up to allow you access. As you walk through into the pyramid, you are greeted with pure, brilliant white light. You shield your eyes, and before you, you see a winding corridor leading you up into the pyramid. Begin to make your way through the winding corridor. Feel yourself moving up and round, and around you go, climbing higher and higher. The corridor is very narrow as it moves higher up through the pyramid. At the end of the corridor, you enter into a chamber. As you look around, you see in the center of the chamber a beautiful large flower growing out from the floor, its petals glistening like gossamer silk. The flower is the source of the light, and you can feel its potency as you are bathed in its radiance. In front of the flower, embedded into the floor, are five large amethyst polished flat crystals. The man asks you to hand him the pyramid. He tells you to lay on the crystals. You lie down on the floor, ensuring you place your head on the first crystal. You realize that the second amethyst covers the back of your heart chakra, and the third large crystal amethyst is underneath your feet. In alignment with your right shoulder is another large amethyst. You stretch out your arm so your hand is resting upon the crystal. to your left, in alignment with your left shoulder, you see another large amethyst crystal. You stretch out your left arm until your hand rests in the crystal. You realize that you are now in the position of the cross. The man tells you it is important that you activate the sacred geometry points within your physical body if you are to enter into the halls of Amenti. This activation will enable you to experience the Christed energy fields that all souls possess. He tells you it is very important that you are still and open-hearted for the activation to take place. You tell the man you are ready, and the flower of life begins to rise up holographically, and the petals become flames of light. The flames of light bathe the chamber and you in light. You feel the energy activating the amethyst, and you feel energy in your crown chakra moving in a small column of purple light, moving down through your body and connecting to the energy building within the heart center. You can feel light activating your hand chakras. You feel light moving through your arms to meet with the light from your heart chakra. You become aware of strong, radiant energy moving into the soles of your feet, activating your feet chakras, and as the energy gets stronger and stronger, you feel a column of light moving up through your legs, into the base of your spine, and up into your heart. This energy that is surging through you is powerful, yet different from all other light you have ever experienced. Feel this energy lifting your body up. Feel every cell being filled up with light. Breathe in the source of life. Connect with your pure essence. I will leave you for 2 minutes to inhale this energy and experience this activation. The energy around you now begins to change. You can vividly feel the energy spinning around you. As you watch, you can see it manifesting into a Merkaba of light around you. As it encloses you, you feel a new energy coming into your body. Your own crystalline, sacred, geometric points are being activated. This is the Christed Light Energy Field. Take 2 minutes to experience, connect, and anchor this energy into your body. Feel your consciousness and your intuitive abilities completely opening and becoming heightened. Feel this influx of powerful energy as it surges in and through you. You are now a fully conduit of Christed light energy. The man steps forward and hands you the quartz crystal pyramid. He tells you that he cannot go any further with you, and that if you are to be granted access to the halls of Amenti, then the rest of the journey you must travel alone. He tells you that he will meet you again in the future. He ushers you towards the center of the flower. Before you enter, the man tells you it is important that you understand the halls of Amenti are a time portal. It is the gateway between your universe and other universes. If you are ready and access is granted, the flower will, once you step into it, turn into the staff of Amenti, you will be immersed in blue flames. When the flames have transmuted all your negative energies, you will be given access to Amenti, and the sphere of Amenti will appear and open up above you. Do not be afraid, he tells you, for during this time you will be watched over by the Ra Confederacy and taken to the Great Library of Amenti. Here you will be given access to the book that holds your divine blueprint and contains information that you need to know at this time. You thank the man for his assistance, and then you ask him his name. He tells you, "My name is not important, but if it pleases you, my name is Melchizedek." He smiles at you and you thank him once more. You step into the flower and immediately the flower transforms into very large, fiery blue flames. You feel your whole body vibrating with positive energy. As the energy becomes stronger and stronger, above your head, you see and feel a large morphogenetic energy sphere beginning to be created above you. You can feel your higher chakras being fully opened, and as they open up, you can feel yourself being pulled up as though your whole body is being stretched. As the intensity of energy builds, you feel yourself being pulled up and into the sphere of Amenti. Feel yourself morphing and changing into light energy. You're moving quickly through toroidal fields, wormholes. Feel yourself traveling through the portals. In a blinding flash of white light, you find yourself inside the halls of Amenti. In the center of the hall is a very large gold table, and upon it lies a very large leather-bound book. I will leave you for 5 minutes to explore the halls of Amenti and to read information that is important to you at this time. You close the book and look around you. You notice that at the end of the room, the wall looks like it is fluid, moving. You move towards the wall. You can feel yourself being gently pulled towards the wall. As you get nearer and nearer the wall, you feel a force field pulling you through the wall. Once more, you can feel yourself moving quickly through wormholes. The rush of energy is uplifting and exhilarating. You feel a new surge of life energy coursing through your body. Once more, as quickly as you entered the wormhole, in another flash of blinding white light, you find yourself back in the castle library. You look around and see a chair and a sofa has been placed in the center of the room. You go and make yourself comfortable and lay back. Memories of your experiences in the halls of Amenti come flooding back to you. You close your eyes, and as you relax, you become aware of how comfortable you feel. You notice the gentle rise and fall of your chest. You realize you are back in your own home. And as you open your eyes to look around you, you find yourself back at home, fully relaxed. When you're ready, be sure to drink some water to help ground you back to the earth.